me find my way. Messing me up my whole head, teasing me just like Tita did Martin. Now look at what you starting. Schoolboy crushing it, ain't on the hush, the whole world see it, but you can't. My peoples, they complain, sit and rave and rant.
Let me ask you a question. What would possess a man who is 6'4", 270 pounds, to drive a four-cylinder hatchback? Let me give you the answer. Mini Cooper S. Stay tuned. If you miss this one, you better be dead. Now, when people think Mini Cooper, there's a lot of stigmas that you can understand. We don't have to get into all that, but here's the challenge. It's not about who you are before you drive the car. It's about who you are after you drive the car. What we're about to witness is the blissful driving experience that is the Mini Cooper S. Now, I've got to admit it to you. When I first looked at this vehicle, when my brother first bought it, I said, I don't know. But after driving it, not only do I know, but I know what you should do. This car's for you. Come on, I'll show you why. Now, this vehicle's been lowered an additional 2 inches. I know what you're thinking. 2 inches isn't a lot. But trust me, you'll feel the difference. Because what you're gonna find, performance improved. Curves, tighter. Grip of the road, amazing. It does not get any better than this. As I said before, it's like driving a go-kart that goes fast as crap. Now, if you're like me, you're thinking 2,600 pounds. You're thinking 200 horsepower. What does that mean? That means the power to weight ratio is stupid off the charts. That means this vehicle that drives like a go-kart but performs like a BMW is stupendous. That means the styling, the overall impression of what you feel is something special. On the pre-owned car market, you can catch something like this for under $10,000. And a few small improvements, and you'll get your socks blown off when you get in this thing. There's nothing left to say, but watch me drive. Check this out. The sensation of speed in this thing is amazing. Oh, by the way, this is the 280-pound guy I told you about. How do you feel about this car, man?
I don't know. Feels like I keep getting heavier and heavier. I don't know. As far as the car goes, though, I love it. There's not very many things you can say bad about this vehicle.
Yeah, I agree. The sensation of speed, like I talked about, flat out amazing. Growliness of what you did to the muffler, I think that's important. It helps the exhaust note sound good when it winds up, and this thing can hook a corner like can't nothing can.
That's the thing. See, people always look for the biggest horsepower car they can find, and I really think that's a mistake. This car, at this part of weight ratio, really provides an exquisite amount of horsepower for the weight. You feel like you're really doing something. You feel like you're really enjoying yourself when you drive it. Don't get me wrong, I've been in faster cars, but I haven't been in more enjoyable cars. Not many.
Yeah. I'll say this. It's like Frankenstein Brothers always says. It's not about how many ponies you got. It's about how you ride that pony. You better know that.
You're lying. And 9 times out of 10, I know you're trying. So I'm trying to be fair.